Weight Science 101. The World Health Organization defines overweight and obesity as abnormal or excessive fat accumulation that presents a risk to health. A crude population measure of obesity is the body mass index, or BMI, a person's weight in kilograms divided by the square of his or her height in meters. Obesity is recognized as chronic, treatment-resistant, progressive, and often relapsing condition, and has been recognized as such by the Canadian and American Medical Associations and the World Health Organization. Much like other chronic diseases, children and youth with obesity can live full and fulfilling lives through a healthy, realistic, and evidence-based approach to weight management. In this video, we will review 1. The effect of genetics and biology on weight. 2. Hormones, hunger, and body weight regulation. 3. Metabolic adaptation. And 4. Treatment options. Let's start off with number 1, the effect of genetics and biology on weight. Our risk for obesity is biologically driven and weight regulation is complex. Our body shape and size is largely genetically determined. Just like tall parents are more likely to have tall children, parents with higher body weight are more likely to have children with higher body weight. Exposures while we are growing in utero can also modify or program how genes are expressed. For example, cigarette smoking, diabetes such as gestational, type 1 or type 2 diabetes, and trauma, including intergenerational trauma, can change gene expression. We now know that the bacteria and other microorganisms that live in and on us can impact our body weight through multiple mechanisms, including how nutrients are processed and absorbed, and alterations in inflammatory and immune pathways. These genetic and biologic risk factors mediate how our body responds to weight-promoting stimuli in the environment, and this leads to continued weight stabilization in some, weight gain, and weight gain with health-related complications in others. Number 2. Hormones, hunger, and body weight regulation. Body weight and appetite regulation is a precise biological process that involves integration of peripherally derived mechanical, metabolic, neuronal, and hormonal signals with the central nervous system. Much of this happens without our awareness. Let's review 2 of the many hormones involved in weight and hunger regulation. Leptin, a hormone made in fat cells, is the primary hormone reflecting our nutritional status and is released in proportion to fat stores. It acts at the level of the hypothalamus to suppress food intake. Those with a high body weight require higher levels of leptin to feel full and well-nourished, while those with a lower body weight require lower levels of leptin to feel equally full and well-nourished. Weight loss leads to a drop in leptin and results in a very strong starvation signal to the brain, promoting weight regain through an increase in hunger and a decrease in energy expenditure. Another hormone, ghrelin, is produced by cells lining the stomach and promotes hunger. It rises just prior to a meal and decreases after feeding. If a person loses weight through dieting or a new exercise program, their ghrelin levels will increase in response to this weight loss, resulting in an overall feeling of increased hunger and weight regain. These hormonal changes can last indefinitely following weight loss and can largely explain why most diets do not result in sustained weight loss. Weight loss also results in significant physiologic changes called metabolic adaptation. Number 3, metabolic adaptation. Let's describe what this looks like. Before weight loss, the metabolic rate is normal for body size. With weight loss, the resting metabolic rate decreases to conserve energy and is lower than what is normal for a smaller body size. For example, if someone weighs 300 pounds and reduces weight to 270 pounds, to maintain this weight, the individual needs to eat less and spend more energy than someone who has always been 270 pounds. If the weight is regained and the individual is once again 300 pounds, resting energy expenditure remains lower than it was prior to weight loss, and now the person must eat less and spend more energy than when they previously weighed 300 pounds. This is why yo-yo dieting is particularly problematic and often leads to ongoing weight gain over time. Number 4, treatment options. So what does a healthy approach to weight management look like? Engagement in weight management through intensive lifestyle programs will improve health, but expected changes in body weight are modest, often ranging from a 3 to 5% change in body weight. There are very few pharmacotherapeutic options for weight management in teens, and researchers have only found modest benefit above lifestyle intervention, and the side effects can be problematic. Individuals successfully engaged in weight management will experience improvements in physical and mental health, but will more than likely continue to have obesity. Bariatric surgery is the one intervention that disrupts some of the neuroendocrine pathways we discussed earlier. Success from bariatric surgery is dependent on implementation and sustained engagement in a healthy lifestyle first as a foundation. Bariatric surgery is a major surgery that requires a lifetime of commitment, hard work, and sustained behavior change and is just one tool in an individual's overall weight management plan. Bariatric surgery can result in a 20 to 30% decrease in body weight on average. However, some weight regain is common over time. It is important to remember that not everyone with obesity needs to lose weight, and not everyone with obesity will be healthier with weight loss. In conclusion, while it is important not to ignore weight or obesity, the focus should be shifted to health goals, not weight goals. Be realistic and honest with your patients about expected outcomes. For those with severe, complex obesity, be honest about the limitations of the interventions that we have to offer as we continue to work towards developing more innovative and effective approaches to weight management, and continue to motivate them to make small, sustainable behavior changes. Be sure to watch A Word About BMI next.